Okay, everybody, we have something kind of simple going on here. I have a switch embedded in the tree, and when I interact with it, hit the E button, I get some shield, and you wouldn't know it, but I get all my shield and health back, and I am also invulnerable. So just by clicking a button, we're going to make something happen inside of Verse, or with Verse inside of the game, so that we can control some stuff. So I'll show you how I'm invulnerable here. I'll go up to our guy, and there he is. And he shoots me, and his buddy shoots me, and nothing happens. Oh, where'd the other guy go? Let's take a look at that. Okay, so we're inside of UEFN. And the simplest part of this is quite literally placing a button. If you go into Fortnite here and go into devices in your content browser, you can just type in button in the search and find a conditional button, which I did a tutorial on before, and a normal button, which I haven't done a tutorial on yet. So this is it. So when we interact with this button, we're going to make something happen. The thing we're going to make happen is this item granter here, again, in the devices, put in item granter, and you get an item granter. Go ahead, chuck that onto the scene. And then inside of here, we can add an item in our item list, and I've added a shield potion. So if you just click into that area there and just put in shield, scroll down, you can put in whatever you want for shield. I put in a shield potion and just one of them. So when the button is pressed, we want to trigger this thing. And we want everybody who gets one, who clicks on the button, to keep all their stuff, but get a shield potion. And we'll grant it. We'll grant this current item. Or all items, for that matter, if you have a bunch of items in there. So current item would be one, the first one. And that's all we have to do inside of the details for this object. So as for the button, there really isn't anything to do inside of our details panel. We have this on interact, but we can't do anything with it in the panel here. We have to do that inside of Verse. So let's hop into my game manager. And again, I've covered this before. A game manager file is just your Verse code living inside of your game. I call it game manager. You can call it whatever you want. Now, inside of here, I have two things that are happening. I've got an editable shield button object, which is a button device, which is the button, except that's how you reference it in Verse. And we have the editable shield spawner, which is an item granter device. Now, when we add these two things in here, and then we go up to the top and we hit Verse, build Verse code, you can then go into your little console here. You can either find it on the in the scene or go find it inside of your outliner, which mine should be a little bit more organized than this, but for another tutorial. And you can see all my editable items in here. And the shield button is set to be the button that I've got in the scene. And the shield spawner is the shield granter, which I named inside of the outliner. So those two are now connected up to our code so we can access them. So if we go into Verse here, these two items are now accessible via Verse, which is really, really handy. So the first thing we want to do is we go into our onBegin function, and down inside of here, we're going to respond to the shield button's interacted with event. It's a thing that you can do. So if you want to know everything that you can do with a device, just control click it, and it will go into the fortnite.digest.verse file. And button device here has all kinds of stuff. But the thing that we're interested in is the interacted with event, listenable or subscribable event. Thing that happens, you click it, it makes it go. So we've got that figured out right here. Shield button, interacted with event, subscribe, on button click. So this isn't a very descriptive function name. It's good enough for what we're doing for a test, but we'd want to make this more describable thing. On shield spawner button click, that idea. And here we have it defined. So on button click passes in an agent object. The agent is the character that clicked it. So if I click it or somebody else clicks it, it's going to pass that through to the button. So the button says, okay, this character here clicked it. Now, when you get that, you can just straight have the item granter grant an item. And again, if you want to know what item granters do, control click on the device object, and you'll find out that you can do grant item, and then you just pass in the agent, and it gives whatever's in the item granter, and you're done. That's it. That's what you want to do if you want to give something to somebody. But if you want to do a little bit more mess with the character, using an if statement, because when we get the fort character, so the get fort character uses a decides method to make it do its thing, I guess is the best way to put it. And when something uses a decides, you have to wrap it in an if statement. So it's very simple. Just put if colon and then do your thing with your fort character. Grab the agent object, which is here. Get fort character. Assign it to CHR or whatever you want to call it. Super character. Who cares? This is a variable. It doesn't matter what you call it. Defined as a fort character object. And then go ahead and set the shield and set the health and set vulnerability to false will make you invulnerable. You won't be eliminatable. If you set it to true, so say you put it on a timer and it goes back to being true, then you're back to normal. But false will set you to being Superman and you'll never be eliminated ever, ever. So hopefully that's been interesting. That's how to get a button to be useful inside a verse and make something happen to a thing. You can do anything. You know, this is just affecting the character itself, but you can do stuff all over the place. Anything inside a verse. So that's it for this one. And see you guys in the next one.